Rakushokubo.
Okay.
This, when we're talking about Rikimi for Bojutsu, is not, we're not talking about necessarily rolling or that kind of thing, or Kaiten. We're looking at it in terms of receiving an attack, mainly from either an attack with a sword, another Rakushokubo, a Jo, or Hanbo, can be anything, or a sword, anything. Okay. So this, we're going to start, let's start in Hiro Ichimoji. And what's going to happen is, you're actually going to move forward with this at an angle, at a 45 degree angle almost. And you're going to bring your weapon up. This is important that the rotation of the shoulder was straight up and down. If this doesn't happen, your hands will actually get hit when you do this. So from here, you're going to bring your arms out and up. And you're going to step forward to your left, bringing this here, and rotation up here. So this now stops my fingers from being hit from a weapon that comes down. And it's important with this leg being back, because this allows the attack to, if it comes, if it hits, it'll just slide down and away from me. Okay? We've done at speed, it would be this. Usually seen with this would be in some sort of an attack with that also. So here, boom. Okay. So once again, you're here, here, here. Bring your attacker down. Okay. If I do it on the other side, okay. So if I'm facing here. Again, I can't stress enough the importance of the shoulder and this hand being aligned over the head. A lot of times I've seen people do this where they'll do it out here, and what happens is their fingers will get hit here. Okay? So again, look at the rotation of the shoulder here. This is up. The fingers are in line. My left hand or my right hand is forward, so that this keeps this weapon away from, or keeps my fingers from being hit. Okay. Here. Here. Okay. Alright. Next we're going to look at if the bow has been knocked out of your hand, or you've hidden it somewhere, and you need to get it back up, get it into your hand quickly. If you do this, it can actually look like a bow just appeared out of thin air at night, if you can do this correctly. It does take some practice. Alright, once more. There we go. And you want to try and get the middle of the weapon. It's very difficult. So here. There we go. Just like that. That's a kid. Next we're going to look at Bo Fiori Gata. Okay, this is spinning the bow. When we normally do this, the bow is coming up from the bottom, coming rising up, as in like an Age Uchi. With this one, this is usually used to striking to the kote, the wrist. It can also be used to striking to the groin a lot of times. Okay. I'll also show you a method of spinning it forward over the top, and also when we're spinning it back, adding an extra spin to it. Okay. The various hand positions, so I'll go over those. The main key things to remember with this, it's going to sound strange, is motorcycle, baseball bat, golf club. When I say these, it's the actual hand position that I'm holding when I'm holding the bow. So this helps to help remind it. I gotta give credit to this Ken Lux. He taught me this when I first started training with him. I've never forgotten it, and I've always teach this to my students. So we'll start in Ichimonji. Here, we're going to be facing here to my left. What we're going to do is we're going to go, now we're at this motorcycle position. We're going to transition to baseball bat. So as we go, we're going to transition to baseball bat, then we transition to golf club as if we're hitting a golf club. We're going to come back, transition to motorcycle, baseball bat, golf club. Motorcycle, baseball bat, golf club. Motorcycle, baseball bat, golf club. And eventually, this becomes very smooth. You can travel forward with it. You can travel backwards with it. Okay? Another we're going to look at is adding an extra spin to it. You have to watch the hand positions on this. I'm going to try and go slow on it. So I'm still doing the thing we did before. Motorcycle, baseball bat, golf club. But as I come here, instead of catching a motorcycle, I'm going to catch and let it spin one more time. Here. Back to here. There. You saw me mess up a little bit there. That's okay. Okay. I transition back to the original one. Bofrigata. Okay. So next we're gonna look at is coming over the top, striking down. So this would be striking to someone's the top of someone's head. It could be striking to the top to the kote. We strike to the elbow area also. So with this one, striking an ichimonji, you're actually gonna step forward with this, strike with the back end of the bow. So as you're coming in, striking, you're coming back underneath, your hands are coming underneath, as if, I don't know if you guys all remember when we were young, we took karate. I'm not talking modern day karate, I'm talking about Okinawan karate, where they had you stand in that horse stance, and you're here, this kind of thing. That's the position you're in, that I'm transitioning to. So from here, stepping, my hands come in, come back over, and I come down again on the head. Here, here, here. Here, here. Okay? So, that's a way of doing it, coming down over the top. Another thing I want to talk about is hand transitions in this art. A lot of times we'll do something where we'll be here and we'll go here. I call it a hand exchange. So if you think about if I'm here facing this direction, but I want to then face someone here, is if I'm like this in Sigon, bring my feet, my hands together, okay, and I go to the other side. Together, other side. Okay? This would also work if I am facing the same direction. Okay? Let's say I have a wall over here like I do here. And I know no one's going to come through this wall. But I can still have an attacker from my right side. What I can easily do is do that hand transition because I know that wall is there to back me up. I can now engage a target that's over here or a threat that's coming from this side. And it opens my field of view also. Okay? So, again, a hand transition. Coming up and back. Up and back. And you'll see this used in various ways. It'll be up high, it'll be low. You'll see us do things where we're striking. Okay? Okay? I'll cut it. Drill we're going to do is Ashibarai. So what's going to happen is we're going to step in and strike for Ashibarai. Okay, from here we're going to bring up, strike again, pull back to get on, strike for Ashibarai, pull up, get on again, and step back. So here, here, here. Here, back. Two, three. Next, we're going to look at Men Uchi. Men Uchi. Okay? So this one is the second part of a kata called Goho. It's taught as a basic... Men Uchi is taught as a basic form before that. Because it encompasses both your gato. Okay? So Men Uchi will start... Transition back to here. Strike yo with ashibarai. Strike to yokome. Slide it back. Strike ashibarai. Come up to sort of a modified jora no kumai. And then we're going to do a hand transition and strike down to ashibarai again. And we're going to come right back to Ichimonji. Okay? So, Ichi, Ni, San, Chi, Go. Ichi, Ni, San, Chi, Go. Here. So this is just a drill. Ichi, Ni, San, Chi. Okay? One, two, three. We're gonna do Goho. Goho. This is the first bo kata from Shinryu. Okay. Starting here. We're gonna basically do both your gata four times. So Ichi, as you come here, strike low, strike high, transition back, come up to Jora no Kamai, and this is Kyojutsu. The idea is you're supposed to fake like you're throwing it, but you actually don't. And then transition again, down low. Okay? So once again, go for your gata. Boom. Strike low, strike high. Strike low. Fake. Come low. Okay? Some tips on this. Learn to move around the attacker's sword, his blade. Because you do a lot of things you don't want to, a lot of people see these movements and they think it's straight. You're moving straight in and straight back. But you're actually moving around his weapon on either side. So if I look at this line here, I want to be moving here and here to evade his tip of his weapon. Okay, once more. I'm fixing the camera here. Transition back. Two. One. One. Two. Three. Four. Okay, we're going to do Goho. We're going to go through all the Bojutsu kata that we did earlier. But this time we're going to do it in armor. So we have to see how it's different. Usually when we do this, we were in our gi, and we are doing it, and our elbows are nice, tucked in, close. Well, when you're in armor, you have weapons around you. I have a tachi here on my left hip, you know. We might have several other weapons, wakizashi or tanto, or a yoroi doshi in our belt. And your hands, you won't be able to have your hands down, you know, down around your waist or in close. So you have to be aware of your weapons. So when we do both your gata, we're going to spin it away from the body. Okay? So here we go. So for your Ichimonji, I'm going to spin, 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 spin. As I come back, I'm going to strike low, strike high, back, boom, and going up high, boom. Next, we're going to look at Uragoho, the second kata from Kukishin Ryu Bojutsu. Okay? So, starting here again, okay, Ichimonji, we're going to do both for your gata. Ichi, Ni, as we come here. Now, normally when I teach this, I teach it doing it four times, the bow fury gata part, but you can do two. So, if it's here. As you go here, oh, one more time. As you go here, pull it back. This is important. Pulling this back. This is part of the kyojutsu. So as you pull it back, the uke sees that this weapon is coming back and you're coming back. You almost want to dip your shoulder a little bit. So this invites your head in. As he starts to come in from Daijodan to attack, ski. Pull this back. Strike to Yokomen. Slide it back. Strike up with the Aga Uchi. Do a hand exchange. And strike to Yokomen. If you think about this with someone with a kabuto on, someone with a kabuto on getting struck here, remember, with armor on, you're top heavy. You're knocking them down with the bow. Okay. All right. Once more. So from here, pull it back. Ski. Yup. Yup. Pull. Right here. Yep. Back. Strike. Strike. Up to Yokomen. Come in. Yokomen again. Right here. Back. Ski. Up to Yokomen. Aguchi. Okay, next we're going to look at Sashi Ai. Okay? Starting in Tsura no Kamae, we'll be here. We're going to ski, strike to Yokomen, and strike to Kinteki, or Suzu, the growing area. Okay? So I've seen two versions of this. Okay? Another version would be to go ski, strike to Yokomen, and strike to the groin again. Chudan, ski, strike to Yokomen, strike to Kinteki. Or Suzu, or here, ski, strike, and strike. And come right back. Sashi Ai. You're here, you're here, you're here. Ski, strike to Yokomen, strike to Kinteki, or Suzu. Okay, other version would be here, or here, ski, ski, strike. Okay, one more time, here. Next one we're going to look at is Funabari. Okay, this one's going to start in Gera no Kamae. Here. Okay. We're going to step in. We're going to strike to, we're going to do Do Uchi, so striking the body area. We're going to pull it back. We're going to strike over the top. Kara Takawari. Take the Suzu. And then back again to Kara Takawari, striking the top of the head. Okay. So once again, here, 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 here. Okay, once again. So here, so each knee, sun, see. Once more. One, two. Three, four. Okay. If you try, This one, we're going to start in Tenshinokuma. Okay? Now, depending on your distance with this, if you're far away, you're going to advance forward. If the attacker is advancing towards you, you can actually step back. If you're kind of at a stalemate, you're kind of moving side to side, you can drop straight down. What I mean with this is, if the attacker is too far away, I'm going to step forward with my right foot and drop the bow. In which what's happening is it's striking his front foot. Okay? If he's in Seiga no Kamae, his right foot will be forward. Okay? So I'm actually advancing forward with that. If I'm going where distance wise we're like right in front of each other, and there's more of a lateral movement or a circular movement in the sense of moving around each other, I would drop straight right where I'm at. So I would actually just basically switch feet and do it. Okay? And if I need to move back because he's advancing, say he skis, I'm almost like retreating. I'm doing it also. So three forms of footwork you can do with this. Okay? So we'll look at the basic one. We're going to move forward with it. We'll drop straight down. So we're here. You're going to step forward slightly. Drop down, striking his foot. Pull the weapon back. You're going to come across Ashibarai. Stand up. You're going to strike to Yokomen. And then you're going to do a hand transition and flip, striking to the top. So you're striking the top of the uke's head. Okay? From here, you're going to slide it back. Strike to Yokomen again. And then Ashibarai. Okay? So once more. Here, maybe move around a little bit, try to gain some distance from there. Step in, strike. Here, 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 here. Okay, once more. Tenshinokuma. Stepping in, strike on the foot. Ashibarai, stand. Yokomen, strike to the top of the head here. Yokomen and Ashibarai. Okay. If I do it facing the camera here, Tenshinokuma, stepping in, dropping, coming across the shin, standing, striking to Yokomen. Okay, flipping over the top, striking to Yokomen, in transition, Ashibarai. Strike to Yokomen here and transition to your back. Okay? From here, you gotta flip the weapon around, strike, slide it back, strike to Yokomen again, pass this back around the other side. As it's coming around, strike here, hand transition, and strike to Yokomen on the opposite side. Here. Ski, strike, bring this over. Strike. Over. Strike. Once more. Yep. Strike. Strike. Okay, next one we're going to look at is Takiotoshi. Takiotoshi. Okay? So. Seiga no Kamae, ski, strike, and bring this up behind the back, and over the top, strike, step back, strike, again, Yokomen, and bring this up over the top here, oops, there, in, and around, strike here. So next one we're going to look at is Takiotoshi, okay, had to remove my kabuto and the minpo, because it's getting a little bit too hot. So, we'll do that real quick, okay? So, Takeotoshi, Seiga no Kamae, okay? And it's okay whether the hand is here or here, both are acceptable, okay? So here, when you ski,
trick to Yokomin. Your pull is behind the back. Catch over the top. Strike. Pull me back. Strike again over the top. Release up and over the top here. Striking. Strike. Okay. Once more. Okay. Skeet, strike. This has got to come all the way up and over. Striking. Step out. Comes all the way up and over. Strike. Boom.